In today's episode, I'm going to show you how you can create PDF previews, which is that, with only a few lines of code. And I'm also going to show you the packages you need to install to get it to work on your local machine, which is Poplar and FFmpeg. Let's jump in. We're going to start by just uploading a PDF and seeing what happens. So I've got my PDF here. It's called Sample Blank PDF. So let's go ahead and just upload that. Okay, so this variant line is throwing the error in variable. And what this pretty much means is for this file type, which is a PDF, we can't actually make variations of it, which kind of makes sense. I guess that's a terminology thing. Instead, we have to create a preview of it, which is fine. So let's see what that does. Okay, we now get the error unpreviewable. So this is because my current machine doesn't have the libraries installed. Figuring out what libraries I needed to install was a bit tricky because the error didn't kind of explicitly say it. I ended up on the Active Storage preview documentation where it has this little note here where it says if you want to preview videos, install FFmpeg, and if you want to preview PDFs, you want to install Poplar. This is also mentioned on the Rails documentation for Active Storage. There's a big red message here, which I kind of glanced over. Very quickly, Poplar is a PDF viewer where you can kind of export what the PDF looks like for your terminal. Almost something like this, which is quite cool. So lots of handy stuff in there. So we're going to install this library to make it work. And FFmpeg is, again, another command line tool, which lets you kind of pull out screenshots and videos or adjust timing and stuff on the terminal. They're quite fun to both play around with, but we're going to use the Rails wrappers today. I'm using Docker to run my site right now, so I'm going to just edit my Docker file. I've got a few things in here. We're just going to add like a new line here, just underneath this. And we're going to say we want to add the Poplar utils. And we're also going to want to do FFmpeg. Should be good. Let's do Docker compose build. That's just going to download those packages and rebuild our little Docker container so we have them all available, which is pretty sweet. Docker, cool, that's done. So we're going to now turn on Docker for our app. Awesome. Cool, there we go. It's just created a preview of that PDF, which is a lovely image. Brilliant. Just like the variants, we can change the size of the preview pretty easily by just changing that one line. So there you go, it's a bit bigger now if I wanted to make it really small. Yeah, that would also work, which is really nice. Let's have a look what would happen if we were to now just upload maybe a video. Let's give that a go. So pull this over. Got all the little clips here. We're gonna put in a movie. Let's see what happens. Okay, that's cool. It's just taking the first frame from that video. That's pretty nice. We can probably configure how that works a little bit, but let's see what would happen if we uploaded an image now. What would happen there? Okay, so we've got a nice JPEG. And oh no, we've got an unpreviewable error. Okay, well this is because our images we can't create previews of, which is kind of annoying. But there is a nice solution to this. So if I were to do if post avatar previewable, we can wrap that in an if statement. And we can also do like a little else if. And we're going to say variantable, I believe. Okay, like, yeah, variable even. Oops, variable. And if it's variable, we can use a variant in here instead. Cool. There you go. So that's now calling this line of code here. And if I was to drop in my PDF again, we can handle both of those both of those file types. In reality, we probably will have some kind of validation to say like, hey, an avatar must be an image. But I think if you want to be like totally free, that's not a terrible solution. If you're using Heroku, make sure to add the build pack for active storage. They've got it kind of documented here in the README, where you just kind of add this one here right at the top. It will also warn you to add this when you're deploying Rails, and it pretty much just adds FFmpeg and Poppler into your environment, which is really handy. So I really like this feature. Like, to create a PDF preview with like that many lines of code is pretty wild. Like, it used to be so much more harder to do that. And every client's going to be like quite impressed by this little thing you can do. Like, they upload a file and then they're like, oh sweet, I got to see what the file looked like. That's really powerful. I think it would be a bit better if there's a way to encapsulate this logic here. I'm sure it's possible, but I will leave you to go discover that yourself. If you enjoyed this episode, please smash that like button. It really helps other people find these videos and is really good. And if there's something you're interested in and want to learn about, just add a little comment. I read every comment and yeah, it helps me so much. So thank you so much, and I will see you next Tuesday.